Hello, I'm Dr. Shuddha Shoto Sen, Senior Consultant, Surgical Gastroenterology, GI Oncology, Laparoscopy and Liver Transplant. Presently associated with AMRI Dhakuria Hospitals, Ashok Nursing Home in Jodhpur Park, and KDQ Center being my chamber. I was a former Senior Consultant with the Fortis Group of Hospitals, Director of Medica, and Apollo Group of Hospitals. Piles are also called hemorrhoids. They are formed inside the anus. What happens is anus has cushion effects. So there are multiple anal cushions which are suspended by some ligaments of parts. So what happens is because of chronic straining or hereditary habits or poor food habits, due to straining, this ligament of parts tear, they would cause a descent of the anal cushion. The blood vessels that run through the anal cushion, they would actually come down with it, cause stasis and pooling of blood, giving rise to what is called piles. Now the piles would have three, four grades. One would be the early ones, then comes the one that is further descended, third ones are the ones that comes out of the rectum and comes with the swelling, which is called interno-external piles. The fourth one are the piles that is outside and it is very difficult to put them inside by pressure. Now the type one are the ones where the diagnosis would be based on symptoms and the signs and the examinations and the other tests. Now normally the patients would present with most commonly are bleeding, fresh bleeding, and which is painless per rectum. It can be painful, however, because of certain complications, infection of piles or associated fissure, fistula, etc. other problems. Now the other problems that can happen is pruritus, that is itching in the perianal region. There may be a perianal swelling, there may be something coming out per rectum. So varied presentations of piles. Now we would diagnose it with clinical history and then we would do a per rectal digital examination. That is, put a finger inside and see whether it is bleeding, whether it is soft piles, etc. We would do a proctoscopy, a specialized instrument, which would go inside the anus and rectum and see, visualize the piles. In some cases, we may also do a colonoscopy to rule out other pathology in the colon. Colonoscopy per se is not required to diagnose piles because it's a clinical and rectal examination diagnosis. But sometimes we need to rule out the other pathology along with piles. Very rarely there would be also a colon rectal cancer or something. Now coming to once the diagnosis is confirmed, very early stages without bleeding or very early stages with maybe single episode of bleeding, we may manage with good food habits, exercise, lifestyle modifications, then some local diltiazem or cremagel, sucralano, other sorts of ointments along with hip bath, which is a lukewarm water which has to be applied. Or rather, you sit in a tumbler which would allow the heat to go inside of lukewarm water, that's called Sitz bath, and various ointments, fibers and purgatives, etc. But if it goes to stage 2, 3 or 4, where it is larger in size or it is bleeding or it can get gangrenous, it can get thrombosed, it can get infected, or there may be associated rectal mucosal or rectal prolapse, we would always have to go for a surgery. Now the surgery has much evolved. The time-tested one had been you excise, that is you tie the base where the blood vessel is there and you chop it off. Now from there, this was an invasive surgery because this was open surgery. From there, various options have come. Either you can inject sclerosin to actually cause the frying of the piles. You can do a Doppler hemorrhoidal arterial ligation. You can do infrared, coagulation, laser, so many things. But what we have tried everything and realized, probably one of the best methods as of today, amongst all the options, are a Longo's procedure, that is a microsurgery for the entire piles, where we would fire a stapler gun that would not only cut and reattach the slide, which is the basic pathology, but at the same time, it will take out the blood vessels which supplies the piles. So thereby, over the period of time, the piles would heal, and we have done thousands of cases so far, and the success and the rates are very high. And the recurrence rate so far has been pretty low. So, for that matter, various options are still available. Sometimes we also do a hybrid procedure that we may actually fire a stapler, then use injection sclerotherapy or laser or tie the bases, some sort of, or a mucosopexis, something needs to be done. So, depends basically on case-to-case basis. But for that, a proper surgeon who would actually understand, who does a good volume of pile surgery, is the one should be chosen.